Hello, this is a very short tutorial for the iiSE process simulator. Please check the details below for a link for the web-based version of this simulator, so that you can try it yourself. For the example today, I'm gonna use a simple air compression system. For more complex cases, please consider one of these examples coming with the system. For this case, I will start a new project from scratch. Just click here, new project. For the case today, we'll use the process engineering library, not the Wallerstein library. Process engineering library. Okay. By default, only water is selected. There will be no water in our system. Then I will remove it. We'll need nitrogen, N2, and oxygen, O2. By default, the Penck-Robinson model is selected. We'll leave this as is for the example today. Nitrogen and oxygen selected. We're done here. Okay. First thing to do is to add a material source. Just click here, source. We'll get a source here. I'll rename it to atmospheric air. Let's say I want to compress 1 metric ton per hour. I'll start editing a value, give a value, and press enter. Then I'm giving this value, was specified by the user. Let's say it will be at 20 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere. Molar composition will be in percent 79 and 21. Okay. With this, I fulfill the degrees of freedom of this system. Currently, the degrees of freedom are 0, 19 variables. With the degrees of freedom with 0 value, we can run the simulation. We can run the simulation here. By doing this, all other variables are computed as a function of the values I have specified. A common mistake is to provide 2 flows, for instance. Let's say I'm given here 1 metric ton for the mass flow. Let's say I simultaneously also give the molar flow. I should not do that. These specifications will become redundant. I should not give the mass flow and molar flow simultaneously. I should remove one of these values. In order to remove a specification, I start adding the value, remove the value, and press enter. Now this value will be computed by the model and is not specified anymore. Okay, in order to compress this air, I need a compressor. Let's click here, compressor. This adds a compressor to my system. I need to connect my air to the compressor. Left click here, drag, and release. And the connection is done. I'll need an energy source for the compressor. Connect here. Optionally, I can add a sink for my compressed air. By doing this, now I have 2 degrees of freedom. I should specify 2 more values. Typically, I should give the pressure. Let's say I want to compress this air to 3 atmospheres. I should also give typically a efficiency, let's say 90%. Now the degrees of freedom are 0 again, I can run again the simulation. Now again all values are computed. I can see that my air will be at 140 degrees Celsius when the efficiency is 90%. Okay, that's it. This is the very basics for the iiSE process simulator.